Rockford's juvenile crime rate is the reason many organizations take a vested interest in children's futures. We've shown you several clubs across town that aim to help kids succeed.
Yesterday, we told you police arrested five juveniles accused of beating and robbing a man. Dylan Sirocki shows us how youth groups are using this as a learning tool to keep kids on the right path.
When I think about what happened with these young people, my heart is just broken, because at 12 years old, you don't need to be behind bars.
After five Rockford juveniles are arrested for aggravated battery and robbery Wednesday morning, local advocates stress the importance of getting kids involved in youth programs.
When kids are learning, that's something that they got to be in every single day, all day long. Their atmosphere needs to be a learning and educational atmosphere, and not just book learning.
Carl Cole and his wife Diana run the Young Eagles Success, or YES, Club. For decades, they've been mentoring local kids through music. Although COVID-19 has limited the club's ability to put on live performances, Carl says they're holding small group sessions and meeting over Zoom.
We come and talk about how to behave and how to act, how to work together, and we heal social injustice, everything. We're talking about all of that. But they also get a chance to do music, they get a chance to dance, they get a chance to do projects that they can be like the movie stars.
Another option for kids is the local nonprofit Youth Against Violence. Organization leaders offer several group activities designed to help kids grow, including a performing arts program where kids learn to play percussion music.
There's countless stats that reinforce why music education is positive for youth. The morality and the skills that come with it, it carries beyond the four walls. You can actually take it out and apply it with you outside of here.
In Rockford, for your home team, I'm Dylan Sirocki.